I'd just like to say that our thoughts, prayers, condolences go out to the family of Sekou Smith, who's a guy that many of us knew very, very well. He covered the Pacers when I was there for a couple of years, and then went on to a very productive television career. This guy was universally liked, loved, and respected. He was a completely authentic person with great credibility, and very, very sad at age 48 for a life to end. So, our prayers go out to his family, and he will be missed. As for the game tonight, I know there's going to be questions about minutes for the guys returning. There is not a definite finite number. There's a range. And of course, a lot of it hinges on how they're doing as the game is going on. We are in a challenging situation, being at 4,300 feet in the return from the virus. But these guys have done real well with their protocol workout stuff, post being cleared. And so, we feel like they're in a good position, but this is going to have to be a bit of a phase in, which is going to be a challenge.
We'll go to questions. Dwayne Price. Dwayne?
Rick, Donovan Mitchell is not going to play tonight for the Jazz. What changes for you guys knowing that he's not going to be there?
Well, he's a great player. You can say we catch a break with him being unavailable. But in terms of their team, this is one of the most tied together teams with a very efficient, high functioning system. And this is the kind of NBA team that can absorb the loss of a player like Mitchell, particularly on a one game basis, and still play at a high level. I would think that Ingles will start. Ingles has a lot of experience as a starter. He's another playmaker, and somebody from their depth chart will probably come into the mix. I'm not sure who that is. It may be Harrison or Oney or one of those guys. But we've got to really focus on the things that are important for us. In the Denver game, we had too many defensive breakdowns. Our communication wasn't where it needed to be, and that's going to have to be much better tonight.
Mark Folliwell.
Hello, Rick. Thanks for the time. As you look at some of, if not all, of Utah's last nine games and their winning streak, what do you think has been the driving force behind how well they played in that stretch?
Just think it. They have a great coach. Quinn Snyder is a very, very underrated coach. Quietly, he's built this team into a very cohesive group. They're really at the top of the league in both offense and defense. And, when you can do that at a high level, you're gonna be one of the top teams. I haven't analyzed their entire schedule during this stretch. They're always hard to play here. That goes pretty much without saying. And look, these are NBA games, they're hard games. You win nine in a row. I mean, you're doing a lot of things at a very, very high level.
Brad Townsend.
Yeah, Rick. Obviously, a lot of fans were heartened yesterday to find out the three guys were coming back. But I think it also made them wonder, do you have any update on where Max is in progress?
He's making progress. He's been cleared out of isolation. He started his workouts. His clock is ticking at a different rate because you know, his episode was longer, and so on. So, you know, he certainly won't play in either of these two games. Saturday, I suppose, could be a possibility, but I don't know. I haven't had that discussion with Casey Smith, and I haven't talked to Maxie in the last 24 hours. But, you know, the hope is that sometime after this trip, you know, he'll be able to rejoin us and get back out on the floor to play some minutes. I just don't know exactly when that will be.
All right, one more, Kevin Gray.
Hey, good evening, Coach. Obviously, this team has been through its adversity this year with the health and safety protocols. What does it mean from a morale standpoint to get Dorian and Josh and Dwight Powell back, not just on the floor, but also the locker room, the guys?
Yeah. You know, it's they're three of our really upbeat, glue, high-functioning players. I mean, you know, all three of these guys have achieved at a high level in their careers. I think, you know, compared to what people would have predicted, you know, you're talking about two guys that were undrafted. One guy, I believe, was I think Josh was a second-round pick. They're all positive people, very unselfish, and they all play, you know, the defensive end of the floor as well as being proficient offensively. So it's great, you know, it's great. It was a real lift yesterday in practice just to have them in there. As I said, this will be a process of getting them phased back in, and hopefully, you know, it will happen, you know, with some expeditiousness. You know, it's hard to say. The virus is so different with every person, but you know, these three guys seem to be in a very good place. You know, given their circumstances and when they came out of isolation and were able to begin practicing, so we're very hopeful.
All right, thank you, Coach.